cut.
This is Roscoe Henderson. We're up on another issue of Upfront Magazine. We're down at Maddie's Restaurants with proprietor George Butch Hope and Bob McAdoo, Hall of Famer, Rookie of the Year, championship ball player. Butch, how's it going?
It's going great. First of all, I just want to thank you all for coming here and joining us with Bob McAdoo. And really want to thank Kenny Martin and his family for even choosing Maddie's Restaurant to kind of host Bob here today. As you all know, Bob and I go back many, many years along with Randy Smith. And he's been a dear friend of mine for so many years. And just to have him coming back in Buffalo and being in this urban setting is a great thing.
Okay. Sir, how does it feel good to be back, Bob?
Feels fabulous. You know, I'm with family and friends. I'm with the couple that raised me when I first got to Buffalo, King and Joanne Martin. We've been friends forever. You know, they still come down to Miami to see me. And, I mean, this is a whole big surprise for me, you know. Come in and see Hope. I haven't seen Mr. Hope. He was always in the locker room with us in Buffalo. He was hanging with us all the time. He's been a friend for years, but I haven't seen him in years. And it's, you know, it's just great being here with family and friends. I haven't seen their daughter, Kanetha, her husband, Alvin, in a while. You know, it's just great. You know, only time I see them is when we go up to Toronto to play the Raptors. And I just took off vacation this year. I drove up here, believe it or not.
I drove.
I've been driving for days. It's a pleasure. I'm tired, but I'm feeling good.
Well, you mentioned it down in Miami. You're the assistant coach with the Miami Heat. And how is that from the transition of being a ball player to an assistant coach?
A little stressful because your job depends on wins and losses. You know, you got to worry about 12, 15 players, whereas, you know, when you're a player, you're worried about yourself. And you feel like you have more control over the game as a player. Now, you really don't have any control. You know, you go over strategies and things like that, workout players, but it's a totally different thing from being a player. But I'm enjoying it. I've been in basketball all my life. I was happy that I got the opportunity as soon as I got back to Europe to be picked up by Pat Riley down in Miami. And,
well, talking about yourself, I know that you were one of the first power forwards and whatnot. How has the game, have you seen the game change from when you were in the league? Now,
salaries. I mean, the game is still putting the ball in the hoop. You know, the guys are bigger and stronger now. But I think the guys of yesteryear, you know, skill level, we could shoot better. Game was faster. It's a show now. You know, it's 30 teams now versus. Right. When I came to the league, it was probably 20 teams. So you got more people, more jobs. I'm still, you know, I kid with Shaq now. I tell him, you know, our Laker team, we would have destroyed y'all's Laker team. I mean, you just match it up. You against Kareem, no contest. Kobe versus Magic, no contest. James Worthy versus Rick Fox. I mean, I just go on and on.
Right.
I said, there's no way you all could have beaten us. And, you know, of course, he's going to argue that point. But we'll never know.
Right, I got you. what about Butch Hope and Mac? I know Butch used to play with Randy Smith at Buff State.
Well, you know, if playing at Buff State, you got to remember Bob came from a program when he came out of college. Our program was just a Division I level lower than his experience. I think he came out of junior college.
I went to junior college in North Carolina.
Right. Vincennes, right, in North Carolina. So we were playing at Buff State. But we had a great team back in them days. We were part of the Big Three or the Big Four. We was well recognized 3 years. We had 20 or more wins under with Randy's leadership. Randy probably at that time by far was the best athlete in Western New York. Here's a young man who played soccer, played basketball, ran track, high jump, and also he honed his skills on the basketball court. You know, he had a great opportunity when the Buffalo Braves came to Buffalo, and he got a shot. And I can remember we went out to Darien Lake. They didn't even have a uniform for Randy Smith. And Randy Smith outplayed every athlete on the court, and eventually, you know, made the team. And like Bob said, Bob was by, had a Lincoln in 1974, and Randy went and brought him a Lincoln. Bob was making $100,000, Randy was only making $12,000. So the Lincoln, you know, he had to sleep over my house, everybody else's house, but he still had the Lincoln. But that was a great experience. Bob McAdoo, Ernie D, and many more athletes who was playing at that time. Garher, yeah, who's now coaching in the league. He was a great friend of the McAdoo and Randy, but you know, we had some good times, and I think we were a role model for the area. We developed the Randy Smith Basketball League. I mean, a lot of great things came out under their era. So, you know, I hope that we can continue to do pass on, and I'm glad you document this, because you never know, 10 years from now, somebody else can, you know, follow up in terms of the history under Bob McAdoo. But he was a great person, and also he came from a great family.
Well, Mac, before I sign off and give you a chance to give the last few words, I just have to ask you one question. I know you travel all around the world, but would you say Buffalo has the best chicken?
No doubt about it. No doubt about it. And my mother over here, my second mother, make the best cakes in the world. That's right. One of the reasons I came up here. Because Kenny, I had to taste their cakes.
Okay, all right. Well, any parting words that you'd like to share with our audience, sir?
It's just, I'm just happy to be, this is like a second home for me. I'm originally from Greensboro, North Carolina. It was basically the first time I've been away from home. You know, Buffalo and people embraced me. Ken and his family took me in like a family when I first got here. I mean, we're still friends, you know, 30 years later. The people, I even meet people around the country that, you know, they have that Buffalo. Let me throw me that Buffalo jersey. I see people out in the audience. You know, I might be in LA, Seattle, whatever, and they got this Buffalo blue on, and they screaming from the top level, middle level.
You came back just, when that color first came out.
The first color, my rookie year, was the black and orange.
Okay.
This was the second year. I guess they were honoring me. They tried to get close to the Carolina Tar Heels blue color. So, but it's a popular jersey. I mean. The young kids don't know anything about Buffalo, but you know, people who've been around, you know, they know about the Buffalo Braves and how exciting they talk about the Phoenix Suns and their fast break.
Yeah.
You know, you see the old timers, they say it's nothing like the Buffalo Braves.
That's right. Well, sir, it's great to have you on our program, and we'll hope to come down to Miami and visit you.
Okay.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much. And that's all for Upfront Magazine. Thank you very much.